Welcome to my basement upper body workout. Now, a lot of us travel and you stay with friends or family, and you really don't have time to go to a gym because you're there to visit them. That's the last thing you want to do is run off and go to the gym. That's kind of obsessive. But if they have a basement, it is a perfect place to get in a quick little workout. Here's an example of one I did. And I'm starting off with push-ups here. And you'll notice I used a can under my feet to make the push-ups harder. So I started with push-ups, and you'll notice I brought my trusty resistance band here. I always bring a resistance band when I travel because it is great for helping you work out triceps, biceps, and shoulders, things that are a little tough to do if you don't have a resistance band. So I'm doing the equivalent of dumbbell tricep kickbacks here. I have the band attached to a pole. You'll notice the elbow is pinned in space, it's not moving, and I'm just flexing the elbow. So I've done a chest exercise, a triceps. Now we're doing the all-important pull-ups. The greatest thing about basements is that you can always find a place to do pull-ups. Now, be careful that what you're doing pull-ups on is strong enough. The last thing you want to do is break a water pipe in a friend's basement. So be real careful about where you choose. But there's a lot of things you can use that are great for pull-ups. Now I'm going to do a hip push-up here. Do a lever push-up if you can. So this is working more traps along with the pecs. So another great exercise. And if this isn't hard enough, you can do more of a lever. You can also put your feet up on something higher to put more force on the pecs, whatever you want. So after this exercise, I am going to roll over and do crunches because we like to do our core exercises. Now, crunches are great, but I might also suggest you do my rotisserie core workout. That's even better. It incorporates side planks, front planks, crunches, and what else? That's it. So you might consider doing my rotisserie core workout. Or if you're just doing crunches, find something heavy to hold behind your head to make these tougher. Because most people have strong enough abs that the crunches don't do all that much. And doing 10 minutes of crunches is a waste of time. Doing endless crunches does not get rid of the fat over the lower abs. That is a myth. There is no such thing as spot fat removal. So 10 zillion crunches, no, waste of time. 10 zillion of anything is a waste of time. So the next thing I'm going to do here, I'm going to use the resistance band, and I'm going to roll over and do a triceps press. Again, you'll notice I am keeping my elbow pinned in space and just using the triceps muscle here. Now, you can do this standing up too. I think the reason I did this laying down is that it was easier to film because I was down on the floor for push-ups. So you can do this laying down, you can do it standing up, but again, great example of why the resistance band is so important. Now, I did a similar exercise with the resistance band tied to the pole, but this one gives you actually more of a range of motion, but they're very similar. This basement workout, you'll notice, is going to be a little heavy on the triceps exercises. That's okay. Every workout's different. I change every single time. The next time I do a basement workout here, I would probably do legs and biceps, because you'll notice other than the pull-ups I've done, there's been no biceps work whatsoever. Also, there's been no shoulders, so I would probably group the shoulders in with the legs and biceps, which I would do, you know, the next time I had an occasion to go down in the basement. So anyway, I'm almost done with my laying on the ground resistance band. Okay, while we're on the ground, I'm going to do a hamstring stretch. This is giving me a little rest from my lifting routine, because you'll notice I have not rested at all. But it's also stretching the all-important hamstrings. If you have any lower back issues whatsoever, there is a good chance that it's because your hamstrings are too tight. So doing anything that stretches your hamstrings out is very good for your lower back. So I'm going to just whip in a set of stretches here. And the resistance band makes a great handle to pull firmly and gently on your hamstrings if you're not flexible enough to reach your ankle with your hands, as I'm not. So that's why I'm using the resistance band here to do my hamstring stretch. Next up, I'm going to do an ultra-wide pull-up. You'll notice my hands are placed really wide apart here, way further apart than my elbows, and that works out the pecs differently. There's no way I could do this with my feet elevated, but if you're strong enough that even these ultra-wide pull-ups are too easy, then elevate your foot on something. There's always something in the basement to elevate your feet. So we've done, this is our third set of push-ups, so this is a pretty heavy on the pecs kind of workout, but I warned you about that already. So we're going to head into another triceps exercise. This is the third one we've done. So first, I'm actually repeating this one because we did this earlier, but that's okay. Again, the form on this is really important. You'll notice there my elbow is not moving forward and back. It's staying pinned at my side as I'm extending. That's the way you work the tricep. If your elbow is moving, then you're working your shoulders, not your triceps. So this is our triceps. As you can see, resistance bands are not easy. This is little resistance band is pushing me to my limits on triceps here. Great exercise. You do not need weights to get big. Resistance bands are just as tough as weights. You just got to get these big, thick, fat resistance bands here. The tubing resistance bands do not work for anything other than physical therapy. That is it. That is my basement workout. When you're traveling, visiting friends or family, give the basement a try rather than skipping your workouts entirely or wasting an entire half day going to the gym. That's it for now. Auf Wiedersehen.